Welcome everyone to another session of Bharat Ke Paramveer. I, Kaustubh Chavan, on behalf of Indo-Science Education Trust, would like to hand over the mic to Veteran Group Captain Srikant Parvatkar sir and start this session.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I, Veteran Group Captain Srikant Parvatkar from Sangli, welcome all the viewers to episode 15. Today on 28th February 2021, let's begin our journey. As per our custom, we pay our respect regards to all these 21 Paramveer diamonds in the necklace of Bharat Mata. Minimum age 19 years, maximum age 42 years. All these diamonds are shining in the necklace of our Bharat Mata. अब तुम्हारे हवाले वतन साथियों, ब्रीफ समरी ऑफ परमवीर चक्र होल्डर्स ऑफ 1971 इंडो पाकिस्तान थर्ड वॉर. फोर कंबैटेंट्स रिसीव्ड परमवीर चक्र हाईएस्ट गैलेंट्री अवार्ड ऑफ इंडिया. आउट ऑफ देम थ्री वेर पोस्थमस एंड वन वाज अलाइव टू टेल हिज स्टोरी. Last Sunday, we saw Lance Naik Albert Ekka, his bravery, which earned him Paramveer Chakra of 3rd December 1971. After 11 days, we saw the second Paramveer Chakra holder, his bravery of 14th December 1971, the only Air Force officer, flying officer Nirmaljit Singh Sekhon. Last Sunday, we saw his actions. Today, we'll be seeing the actions of Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal, who received Paramveer Chakra posthumously for his bravery on 16 December 1971. These four episodes of 1971 Paramveer Chakra awardees are dedicated to the unsung heroes, martyred, injured, alive or no more, and their family members who suffered enormously as a result of the 1971 war with Pakistan. And all the previous wars India fought, every Indian along with all their generations shall remain indebted to them forever. Today's hero is Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal. Look at his face, young, just 21 years young. Let's move forward. Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal, BCD, date of birth 14th October 1950, date of commission 13th June 1971, date of death 16th December 1971, 6 months. And I would like to share that after 12 years, that is on 14th October 1962, I was born. So date of birth 14th October 1950, Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal. Date of commission, 13th June 1971, at age of 21. And within 6 months, he left his planet Earth for heavenly abode on 16th December 1971. What a life and what a death. Life before joining Indian Army, Arun Khetrapal was born on 4th October 1950 in Pune. Family is proud to have long history of warriors and military service. His great-grandfather was in Sikh army and fought against the British. His grandfather joined British army and participated in World War I. Father, an army officer, sapier, Brigadier M.L. Khetrapal was an officer of Corps of Engineers in Indian Army. His mother, Maheshwari Devi, was a homemaker, and what a home she made. She's no more. Suffered quietly her young son's loss throughout her life. She also left for heavenly abode shortly after Ruchna Bishra Rawat wrote the article on Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal for her book, The Brave. She could not remember anything due to aging and was very shrill when the writer went to interview her. The Khetrapal family belonged to Sargodha in Pakistan and to India after partition as refugees. Arun Khetrapal attended the Lawrence School, Sanawar, that is in Himachal Pradesh near Dalhousie. Proved himself as an able student and a sportsman and was a school prefect. NDA joined in 1967 at the young age of 17 years. He joined 38th NDA course, Foxtrot Squadron. He was Squadron Cadet Captain of the course. Joined Indian Military Academy after 3 years in 1970 and was commissioned on 13 June 1971, posted to 17th for Pune Horse, young age of 21. My personal experience, what I was before joining Army, Air Force, and after joining Armed Forces, was a different person altogether. Arun Khetrapal was commissioned in the Indian Army in June 1971 in 17 Pune Horse. Field Marshal Sam Manekshaw's response to the then Prime Minister around the same time, when it was he was asked if he can take over the or commence the liberation of Bangladesh in the month of May or June, he was straightforward, and as a good commander, he advised Prime Minister to give him 6 months, and when he will prepare, and then in the month of December, he ensured that the 13 days war, shortest world, would be a win for India. So he was commissioned, Arun Khetrapal was commissioned during the same time in June 1971. During 71 war, his unit 17th Pune Horse was assigned to 47th Infantry Brigade, which saw action in Shakargarh sector. This sector, Shakargarh sector, is in Narowal district of Pakistan, east of Sialkot and south of Jammu. The famous the Battle of Basantar was the place, and was famous for the tank battles. The brigade was tasked to establish a bridgehead across the river Basantar. On 15 December, by 2100 hours, they achieved that objective. The place was heavily mined, prevented the deployment of the tanks of the Pune Horse, and the engineers were halfway through landmine clearance job when Indian troops at bridgehead reported alarming armor activity and asked immediate armor support from 17 Horse. 17 Horse decided, if needed, not to wait for mine clearance activity and push forward. Engineers, Colonel Hanaut Singh was the CO of 17 Horse, decided that the tanks would move simultaneously along with engineers clearing the mines and avoid the delay. Every minute, every second in the battlefield is very, very important. They didn't want to waste time. So the now veteran Colonel Chima, who is retired, who was the, as engineers, he was representing engineers. And Colonel Hanaut Singh, Lieutenant Colonel Hanaut Singh, they decided, and it was a simultaneous action. It was the most super coordinated effort by the regiment and the engineers. Colonel Chima's sentence after retirement: the operation is still believed to be miraculous in military history, since not one tank was blown up by a mine and was able to link up with the infantry at the bridgehead by first light of December 16th. It was necessity. What followed was a making of history and display of character, values, and commitment of Indian Armed Forces and its warriors. Actions of Paramveer, first of four slides. On 16 December 1971, at 0800 hours, Pakistan Armor 13th Lancers, equipped with United States-made 50-ton patent tanks under the command of the then Major Nasir. I intentionally have changed the color of the ink. Remember this name, Major Nasir. He was a commanding officer of the 13th Lancers Pakistan patent tanks unit. He launched the attack at Bravo Squadron of 17 Horse at Charpal. Squadron commander Bravo Squadron called for urgent reinforcements because the enemy was in a large number and he needed support. Captain Malhotra, Lieutenant Alawat, and 2nd Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal of Alpha Squadron, stationed close by and the troops are sent to assist the Bravo squadron. They respond with alacrity along with the rest of the regiment. The first counterattack was decimated by coolness by the Indian troop and individual tank commanders from CO, Lieutenant Colonel Hanoj Singh that time, down to its troop leader, Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal. Everybody was on the same frequency, everybody was with the same attitude and josh. The intensity of battle of an Indian attack was so high that within minutes, 7 enemy tanks were knocked off. However, Alawat's tank is also hit and is in flames. Khetrapal's tank also is hit. Captain Malhotra orders him to pull back and bail out. Leave the tank, he said, pull back and leave the tank. But young Indian Arun Khetrapal, at the age of 21, this energy of India is unstoppable. He chases the withdrawing enemy tanks and even manages to shoot and destroy one. The enemy sends in more tanks. In the course of battle, Khetrapal is severely wounded. He asks to abandon his tank, Famagusta. Name of his tank is Famagusta. But he realizes that the enemy is continuing to advance, and if abandoned his tank, they would break through. His reply, which has become the world famous quote of a warrior, he said, "No, sir, I will not abandon my tank. My gun is missing and I will get these dash, dash, dash." Captain Malhotra tells him again, "Don't be silly. You get out of the tank, otherwise you and your crew will be killed." Tank driver Prayag Singh pleads his commander, "Saab, let's move back, douse the flames and come again." Indian energy in the form of 21 years young commander, Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal replies, "Didn't you hear CO Saab on the wireless? He said, no one will pull back an inch." In his blue dungarees, Nathu Singh is a gunner, takes position as the gunner once again. In front of him, the air is dark with fumes. The tanks, damaged tanks, are burning. The flesh is burning inside the tank. Right behind him, standing tall and handsome young commander. He's shouting, "On tank," and Nathu Singh aims his gun and fires. 4 enemy tanks are still advancing when he calmly sets about shooting them one by one. Last tank he shoots has reached 75 yards from his Famagusta. This is the tank of squadron commander of 13 Lancers, Major Nasir. Both of the commanders fire at each other. Colonel Chima was nearby. He remembers it was like one against the other. The Famagusta shudders, and behind him he hears a blood-curdling scream. The shell has come in through the cupola. There is smoke and flesh all around. Nansing, the loader has his, and a radio operator has his head ripped off. He is the first one to be killed, followed by the tank commander. Remaining two of the crews, namely tank driver Prayag Singh and Gunner Nathu Singh, are badly wounded. The brave young Khetrapal has been hit and he collapses. His left leg is arched at an impossible angle. The tank commander is martyr. The tank gunner Nathu Singh looks down to feel a wet patch. He feels that some wet patch on his leg. He tries to touch it and finds a blood all over his hand. Splinters have cut deep into his legs, badly injuring him. Famagusta and her crew ensure that not one enemy tank gets past them. The young man of 21 years has performed an act of courage and self-sacrifice that goes beyond the call of duty. For displaying the highest qualities of valor, leadership, and strength of purpose, Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal is awarded Paramveer Chakra posthumously. The tank commander, the energy of India, young and dynamic warrior, every Indian would love to have son like him, is dead. At the age of 21 years and service age of 6 months, this great soul has given so much to the country and her future generations that we feel like thanking God Almighty for sending this soul on 14th October 1950 and keeping him with us till he completed his assigned job 16th December 1971. In his death, he has taught us so many lessons to the nation India and all of us Indians, our future generations, that less mortals like us would like to bow our head with all humility at our command to this great soul. Citation for the Paramveer Chakra Award. On 16 December 1971, the squadron commander of Bravo Squadron, the Pune Horse, asked for reinforcement as the Pakistani armor, which was superior in strength, counterattacked at Jarpal in the Shankargarh sector. On hearing this transmission, Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal, who was in Alpha Squadron, voluntarily moved along with his troops, versus the other squadron. En route while crossing the Basantar River, Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal and his troops came under fire from enemy strong points and RCL guns nests that were still holding out. Time was at a premium, and as critical situation in the Bravo Squadron sector, Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal threw caution to the winds and started attacking the impending enemy's strong points by literally charging them, overrunning the defense works with his tanks and capturing the enemy's infantry and weapon crew at pistol point. In commander of his troop was killed, Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal continued to attack relentlessly until all enemy position was overcome and he broke through towards the Bravo Squadron position. Just in time to see the enemy tanks pulling back after their initial probing attack on this squadron, he was so carried away by the wild enthusiasm of battle and impetus of his own headlong dash that he started chasing the withdrawing tanks and even managed to shoot and destroy one. Soon thereafter, the enemy reformed with a squadron of armor for a second attack, and this time they selected the sector held by Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal and two other tanks as the points for their main effort. A fierce tank battle have fight ensured. 10 enemy tanks were hit and was severely wounded. He was asked to abandon his tank, but he realized that the enemy, though badly decimated, was continuing to advance in his sector of responsibility, and if he abandoned his tank, the enemy would break through. He gallantly fought on and destroyed another enemy tank. At this stage, his tank received a second hit, which resulted in the death of this gallant officer. Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal was dead, but he had, by his intrepid valor, saved the day. The enemy was denied the breakthrough he was so desperately seeking. Not one enemy tank got through. Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal had shown the best qualities of leadership, tenacity of purpose, and the will to close in with the enemy. This was an act of courage and self-sacrifice far beyond the call of duty. Now, I added a few slides for a better understanding of the civilians. Effects of war on the warriors and their families. 74 years young, Jawan, veteran Risaldar Major and Honorary Captain Nathu Singh, who was the gunner on the tank Famagusta, is settled in Hussainpur in Nagaur district of Rajasthan. He still wakes up in the dark sometimes. These are nights when his memories of Jarpal battlefield of 15th and 16th December 1971 seeps into his dream. He's 24 again, a Savar in the 17th Pune Horse on the battlefield at Barapind, Jarpal, 40 kilometers inside Pakistan. He reaches there, cramped inside Famagusta, out of 10 patents smashed by 17 horse warriors, 4 are by Famagusta alone. He wakes up again after all events of 16 December 1971, 50 years back, completely unfolds again. 50 years have gone, but he still has nightmares about 16th December 1971. He says other people might have forgotten him, Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal, but I still dream of Khetrapal Sahib. I see tanks burning around me. Sahib is telling me to fire. He's standing behind me with half smile on his lips. On tank, Nathu, fire. He's saying, and I fire. Bahut Bahadur Admi Thasab. Other people might have forgotten him, but he will keep coming in my dreams till I live. For me, he will never die. The effect of war after 50 years on the veteran Risaldar Major Honorary Captain Nathu Singh at the age of 74 years after the 71 war, who participated in Fangushta War on the tank. Now we go to family of warriors, the effect of war on the family of warriors. Date 26 December 1971. It's morning of 26 December 1971. Veteran Brigadier Khetrapal, father of second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal, was shaving. Doorbell rang up, heard his wife's footsteps going towards the door. Mukesh, his younger brother, was getting ready to go to college. Mukesh is the younger brother of second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal. He was getting ready to go to college. Ever since the war had started, whole family was living in constant fear. He was glued to the radio, listening to the war bulletins and analyzing where the action was taking place. They knew that a fierce tank fight had taken place in Basantar on 16 December 1971. 10 days has passed, no message, nothing has come from the front. The brigadier had barely been able to eat any dinner that night on 16 December 1971. He knew that was the area his eldest son Arun's regiment would be deployed. All that has passed. The war was over on 17 December 1971 after surrender of Pakistani troops on 16 December 1971. Khetrapals were waiting for return of their son Arun. They had even had his motorcycle serviced and his room cleaned. Front door opened, he hears some conversation followed by a sound that made his hand stop shaving. His blood froze, dry rustle of envelope, changing hands. He sensed the scream before he heard it. He ran across the front door, postman standing at the door, wife lying on the floor with a telegram in her limp hands that said, "Deeply regretted to inform you that your son IC-25067 second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal reportedly killed in action on 16 December 1971. Please accept our sincere condolences." What a response the family could give to this. Now we go to 2001, effects of war on the family of warriors. In 2001, Veteran Brigadier M.L. Khetrapal, aged 81 years, he felt a strong desire to visit his birthplace at Sargodha in Pakistan. He applied to the government of India. He may be permitted to visit this place. In 2001, beginning of 2001, at Lahore Airport, Brigadier M.L. Khetrapal was met by Veteran Brigadier Faja Muhammad Nasir, who took it upon himself to be Veteran Brigadier M.L. Khetrapal's host and guide. Brigadier Nasir really went out of way to ensure that Brigadier M.L. Khetrapal had a satisfying and nostalgic visit to his old house of his childhood in Sargodha. Upon his return to Lahore, he was once again the guest of Brigadier Nasir for 3 days. Brigadier M.L. Khetrapal was overwhelmed by the extreme kindness, deference, courtesy and respect bestowed upon him by the Brigadier and by all the members of his family and his many servants. However, Brigadier Khetrapal felt that something was amiss, but could not make out what it was. Was it the long silences that punctuated their animated conversation, or was it the look of compassion in the eyes of the women in the family? He could not make out, but was sure he was being treated as someone important and very, very special. Finally, on the last night, next day morning, he was to leave Lahore for India. Before Brigadier M.L. Khetrapal's departure, Brigadier Nasir said, "Sir," they were sitting in a lawn in the evening and discussions were going on. Nasir opened the topic. "Sir, there is something that I wanted to tell you for many years, but I did not know how to get through to you. Finally, fate has intervened and sent you to me as an honored guest. The last few days, we have become close to one another, and that has made my task even more difficult. It is regarding your son, who is of course a national hero in India. However, on that fateful day, your son and I were soldiers unknown to one another, fighting for the respect and safety of our respective countries and countrymen. I regret to tell you that your son died in my hands. Arun's courage was exemplary, and he moved his tank with fearless courage and daring, totally unconcerned about his safety. Tank casualties were very high till finally there were just two of us left facing one another. We both fired simultaneously. It was destined that I was to live and he was to die. It was only later that I got to know about how young he was and who he was. I had all along thought that I would ask your forgiveness, but in telling the story, I realized that there is nothing to forgive. Instead, I salute your son for what he did at such a young age, and I salute you too, because I know how he grew into such a young man. In the end, it is character and values that matter. I imagine what the father could respond. Brigadier ML Khetrapala was silent, as he did not know how to react. To be enjoying the hospitality of the person who had killed his son was a confusing feeling. However, being a soldier himself, he genuinely admired the chivalry of an officer whose complete squadron was decimated by his son. Both the brigadiers retired for the night, deep in thought. There were never any victors in the war. Both sides lose, and it is the families that have to pay the price and suffer the most. As someone once said, wars are created by politicians, compounded by bureaucrats, and fought by soldiers. Now we come to the tributes and facts. Indian Army has produced many brave officers who have laid down their lives on the line of duty, but the bravery of Khetrapal has indeed been the highest point in the history of the Army, Indian Army. His bravery is deeply embedded in the ethos of the Army and is evident from the numerous buildings named after him at IMA and NDA, higher than any other officer of the Indian Army. The IMA has its auditorium named Khetrapal, and all passing out officers take oath in front of this building. The IMA also has one of the main entrance gate named Khetrapal. The main ground at NDA is named after Khetrapal as Khetrapal Ground. The tank of Arun Khetrapal was called Famagusta JX202. It was restored after the war and is kept in the Armored Corps Center and School, Ahmednagar. If any of you wish to visit, this will be like a Tirthasthan for you. Man Singh was first to die, the loader and radio operator. This was just before the fatal encounter with Major Nasir. Then Arun succumbed to his injuries. Both Prayag Singh and Nathu Singh, the driver and the gunner, were badly wounded but survived and retired from the army as honorary captains. Arun Khetrapal's mother did not get the news of his death till 26 December 1971. She had got his motorcycle serviced and his room decked up after hearing that the war was over on 17 December. He was cremated on 17 December near Samba district. All his family got was the news on 26 December 1971 and his ashes in a small handkerchief. Mrs. Indira Gandhi, the then Prime Minister of India, met Mrs. Khetrapal, Arun's mother, after the war and told her, "Aap dhanya hai." With tears in her eyes, Arun Khetrapal had gate crashed in the night before his regiment was to leave for the front to meet his mother and say goodbye. What a mother. His mother's final words or warning to Arun, her son, Arun Khetrapal, were, "Fight like a lion and don't come back like a coward." What a mother. This is the Rafale, which is the modernization of Indian Air Force. We acquired this aircraft recently. Food for thought. Soldiers don't die when bullets pierce their hearts and heads through their uniforms. They don't die when they fall before an enemy onslaught, or even when they get buried in trenches, staining the earth with their warm crimson blood, worshipping Mother India with their warm crimson blood as per the traditions of Indian Armed Forces. It's only when we forget their acts of bravery and or suffering of their physically alive families that the soldiers really die. Rachana Bishrawat, in the brave, my appeal, you should not be one of them. Acknowledgements. I wish to acknowledge the fine soldiers for contribution to the completion of this presentation. Photograph of the statue at National War Memorial, New Delhi. This is the source. Then https english.wikipedia.org wiki arun underscore khetrapal. Rawat Rachana Bisht, The Brave Paramveer Chakra Stories, Penguin Publishing House, India, 2014. Rawat Rachana Bisht, Paramveer Gatha, translated by my friend Bhagwan Datar of Rohan Publications, 2017. Finally, Rashtraya Swaha Idam Rashtraya Idam Namam Jai Hind. Sorry if I have got slightly over emotional. 6 months age, service age, 21 years total stay on this planet. What a life and what a death. We all Indians can learn from this to make a meaningful life and give a meaning to the death for the future of India. Thank you very much. I have finished. God bless.